What's going on, you people? This is J Career Travel Judah, and you're back with another video. I am getting ready to make two heart candles and my products I got from the Dollar Tree. The candle wax, I use the candles from the Dollar Tree. The gaming blocks, wood blocks, the chalk paint, and the glass heart. Now this is me getting ready to do the candles, melt the candle down and pour them in the jar that I'm using. Here's a shot of me and how far along the candles are from melting. And this is what you get when you melt them. I retrieved the wick from out the glasses. I used 2.5 with maybe 2 pours for this candle, so you would need a space of 2 candles, but I think about like 6 candles in all. Glue your wick down first. I didn't, but you glue your wick down first. I really didn't care because I knew that the wax was going to dry and would adhere to the bottom of the glass heart. So this is me taking my time. The glass is hot. Mind you, be cautious. It's very, very hot. So be careful when you pour. And I'm just administering it like this because this is my first time making a candle, you all. And it was quite fun to do. See how far it is with just those 2 glasses. And I know the candle might be high before you melt that, but of course it's wax. So it's gonna, just like greens, boil down, the candle boil down too. So just be mindful of how many candles you may need. Those 3 filled it up a little bit more than I would like it to, so I took some of it out just for good measure. And make sure you have a skewer or the candle stick so you can hold your candle wick up so it will not go down into your wax. So what I did was, I didn't have neither. So what I did was, I took the wick and I put it between the blocks and it healed it quite nicely. I'm gonna show a close up. Okay. I just put it inside that block. So that candle is done. I melted these Valentine's Day candies, this brand. I can't see it legally, but I'm not handicapped. Hope everybody's doing well. And their family's doing well. Y'all are safe and secure. Thanking God to see another day. These are the candies that I use. Like I say, they're Valentine's Day candy that I had left over that I wanted to use for this project to make my candle smell good. I used only 1, but you can use how many you would like or whatever you would like to put in your candle. These were initially supposed to be for Valentine's Day, but of course I have things to do and I have a household full of children and a husband to take care of. So there you go. So I just melted it in the microwave and this is what I came out with. Now I did melt it in the microwave, but what you can do, y'all, is what I did the second time. You can put the candy right inside of the wax because the wax is very hot. So you can just cut out the middleman with the microwave if you want. And what I did was just took a spoon and just stirred it around until it mixed with my wax. But to make it easier, I just put it just inside the wax and then it melted right along with the wax. So that is what I did. This is me stirring it. It takes the guesswork out when you just put it inside the wax, y'all. So be mindful of whatever you're using. You may be using actual fragrances for candle wax, but I decided to use this candy for Valentine's Day. But this is going to be for my daily use whenever I want to use it. It's just a little project I thought could be for any time, not just for Valentine's Day. It's some nice decor and it fit right in my decor in my living room, which I am finishing up and everything. I'm still not as finished as I want to be, but I'm almost there. Got a few more things I want to get for my living room before I make it over. So that's 1 candle done. Now this is the second candle to show y'all how I did the first one. This is the chalk paint. This all products from the Dollar Tree. So I didn't even spend the money on the gaming blocks. My son got them for a gift, but I knew that he didn't know how to play the game, and I can always go and get another game if he would want. So I just used it for this project. I thought it would be really cute, and I like the way they turned out. But I will show you what I did to make the shape with the block pieces, y'all. This is just me painting. You know, so I decided to show this part so you can see how it looked before and after. So enjoy. And what I will add, which I'll be showing in a few, if I brush a couple of strokes of the chalk paint. It is chalk paint, and I love it, y'all. I love it, y'all. It is super. For $1, I think I purchased 4 of them, maybe 6. But you can also go to Walmart and get Waverly chalk paint, you know what I'm saying, for the price of 1, for a bigger one. But I just decided to get those Dollar Tree ones because they were convenient. But they do have the same chalk paint. It may be better, but hey, I opted for the Dollar Tree chalk paint, which works it just fine. And what I will add is get into those grooves of those block pieces, y'all, so it won't show up like the block piece colors, the wood color. If you want your piece to be all black and not show that. Now, if you want it to show the wood color, that's fine. It's your preference, but I didn't like it. I wanted it to be jet black. I wanted it to be incognito, baby. Incognito. So what I did was I turned the brush sideways, and I got into the little grooves of those blocks and made it all black. So that's what my reason for showing this part too. See, that's me getting in those grooves, y'all. Getting to see how it look if you don't get in those grooves right in the front there. So make sure you get in those grooves, y'all. And on top, and if you want to do the top and the bottom of the blocks, not the glass. And by the way, I will show, I think I put it in here. If not, I will tell you. It's a couple of pieces that you might have to cut. So if you have a miter box or a miter saw or a knife or anything, they're easy, pretty easy to cut. Make sure you have a sharp knife. This is the finished look, but you would have to cut a couple of those blocks in order for it to fit perfectly. So I'm just letting y'all know. I can't recall if I showed that part or not, but I'm just including it in the narration so y'all will be aware of this. So you won't get the blocks and be like, why is it not fitting? And that'll be why it's not fitting, because they, a couple of those blocks you have to take and cut them down the middle, at least half of it off, or a third of the block, cut it off so it'll be able to fit into the heart shape. Now you can color your blocks any color you will want them. I just chose black because I thought it would look cute in my living room with my black decor I already have. So this will be the second candle, you all. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. If y'all do enjoy my content, like, comment, and subscribe if you wish. It is completely and positively free of charge. You know, you can take a little bit of your time, your free time, and click that subscribe button and then like, and don't be afraid to comment. I like to hear what y'all, you know, I like to know what y'all think. I like to read it. You know what I'm saying? Give your thoughts and everything, or suggestions if you would like. See, this is me putting the candy right directly in the mix. And see how easily it melt right into the candle wax. I loved it. And what I'm going to do is put up my good old trusty dusty wick in the bottom. Like I say, look, glue it down with some hot glue, y'all. Now, I didn't do mine, but I implore you to get that hot glue gun if you have one. And glue that wick down. You see, that's why I tell you to glue it down, because when I moved that wick and my candle wax was drying, it made just a little line in my candle, which was fine by me. But at the same time, you don't want that. So now I am getting ready to pour this hot wax. It has to be a certain temperature, y'all. Dealing with wax and making candles, it may seem easy peasy, but it's a method to it. So do your research. And I may be doing a couple of other candles in up and coming videos, so look out for that. I got inspired by some lady on Instagram. She do her thing, y'all. She has a business where she make candles, and they are beautiful. I try to put a link in the description box if I can, y'all, for y'all to enjoy her video. And this is why you have to glue that wick down, y'all. See, I'm putting it inside my little block, which I really didn't care. I was just trying to get done with this video because I wanted to get done. I've been working on it for several days and off and on because, y'all know I have a big family. And, of course, a beautiful husband. So, there you go. But I'm trying to get this content out for my subbies. So they can enjoy it. Now this is me pouring the candy wax mixture in, and it's just a little cloudy, but it does not mess up the integrity of the wax. I'm gonna let y'all know that right now. It was just fine. And once again, I will tell you, be careful, be aware, because the candle wax is super duper hot. And that one is finished. I haven't cut the wicks off of them yet. I'm going to wait till that one cool down and solidify until I do so. Now, this is my second project. I am getting ready to make a Dollar Tree vase using their cyclone glasses. And, of course, some black chalk paint from the Dollar Tree and a paint sponge. So, that is a total of $4. That's all it take. And I had got the flowers that I put in my vase from Walmart, and they were $3 a bushel. And you can use any flower or arrangement that you want in your vase. I'm just showing you how I did mine. There was a riser that was supposed to go into this vase, but I'm going to do it at a later date, and I may come back and show the finished look of that. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see. But this is how you do this. Of course, everybody knows the typical Dollar Tree vases. We make them. I don't know if y'all seen this one made before. But this is the finished look. Only thing I did was glue the two glasses together and painted them and put the flowers inside. I think it came out really nice. I love it. And I will be showing you the three products, the two candles and my vase side by side, so y'all can get a glimpse of how that look as well. Hope you enjoyed this video. Like I always say, legally blind but not handicapped. Love y'all. Thank y'all for sticking in there with me and standing there with me and not hanging, because if you hang, you eventually fall off. So I thank y'all for standing there with me and enjoying my content and liking my content and everything. And I hope y'all be blessed. Be careful out there. Watch over yourself. Respect God. Watch over your family. And everything. This is everything that you was going to need for everything that I used for the video. Block pieces, cyclone glasses, paint brushes, glue gun, E6000 glue, and of course your wax candles. It's not for me to say you love. Go with the metal, you know how we do.